How are you? Look, this is, I wanted to ask you about this being your last fight, and obviously boxing is a dangerous sport, and doesn't lend itself to nostalgia the way maybe like a Kobe Bryant's last game or something like that is. But as you prepare for this, do you spend any time thinking about this is the last camp, this is going to be the last weigh-in, or do you think back at all to the start of your career?
Actually, I thought that Andre Berto, I thought that was going to be the last weigh-in. I thought that was going to be the last training camp. I mean, just honestly speaking, I thought that was going to be my last everything. But, you know, you just don't never know what can happen. Now, we're here with this big event, you know. So, it's just that this is my last one, ladies and gentlemen. I gave my word to Al Heyman. I gave my word to my children. And one thing I don't want to do is break that. I gave Heyman my word. I gave my children my word. I'm going to stick to my word. This will be my last fight.
Our next question comes from Lance Pugmire of Los Angeles Times.
Hey, Floyd. Good to talk to you. As you look back, as you retrace your steps, kind of building on what Dan was asking you about, you know, you were struggling to gain attention around the area of 2005 before you aligned with Al Heyman. What was really the seminal moment for you that really turned the tide and got everyone's attention for you? Was it more like aligning with Al Heyman and following the plan that both you guys laid out? Was it 24/7, or what exactly do you think turned the tide?
I just want to touch on something. Floyd Mayweather has never been struggling. They're just for starters, so we can clean it up right now. Floyd Mayweather has never been struggling. You know, the thing is this, me and Al Heyman joined forces because when Al Heyman seen me, he seen not just a fighter, but a person with a sharp mind, very articulate and very smart, not just in the ring, but outside the ring. And he knew that we could be a powerful force together. Now, once again, you know, when I fought Diego Corrales, I done good numbers. When I fought Angel Man Freddie, I done good numbers. You know, in the list, before I even got to Heyman, I done good numbers. But me and Heyman together came together and had a game plan. Whereas when I was dealing with people in the past, nobody never really had a game plan. I had a game plan. Leonard had a game plan. Me and Leonard both had a game plan. But it was a missing piece. But when we all came together as one, that's when I came up with a game plan. And they started putting everything into play.
Yeah, and also after this fight, how do you think you're going to spend your life? I know you got Mayweather Promotions, but what else are you going to be involved in, and what are you going to be doing as the day
starts? Well, I mean, my real estate portfolio is truly amazing. You know, I have the real estate, real estate that's very, very huge. That's a huge part of my life. You know, my children are going to college, so that's going to take up a lot of my time. Because, you know, education is extremely important in my home. You know, I want my kids to do something that I wasn't able to do. I want them to be able to go to college. And then in the businesses that I leave for them, I want them to be able to take those businesses and take them to the next level. And, you know, if I took a business and made $100 million, I want them to take it to the next level to make $400 or $500 million. So it's all about giving back. And I built different businesses and got businesses started so my children can take over someday.
Yeah, Lance, it's even just, I know you didn't ask it to me, but I'll answer it anyway. You know, I think a critical turning point in Floyd's career was buying himself out of the Top Rank contract. That is going out on a limb, you know, paying $750,000 with no guarantees on what's going to happen on the other side of that. Without the courage to make that move, without the foresight to make that move, you know, nothing in the rest of this is possible. So, you know, it's easy to sit back and say, you know, and forget that it all starts with taking risk. No one has this level of success without taking a risk. And that's one very tangible point where Floyd put his money where his mouth is, took the risk, and was able to reap the rewards.